Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. And we're here at the 48-Hour Film Project with the co-producer, Ms. Paula Martinez. Mm-hmm. And how long have you been doing this, Paula?
I believe this is our sixth year.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah. And how did you get started? Have you always been in the entertainment industry?
I've been in the entertainment industry since 2006. And I started with the Atlanta Film Festival. And we started doing the 48-Hour Film Project as part of the film festival, and we incorporated it in. And then when Gabe and I left, we took it with us, and we've been producing it ever since then.
Wow. And did it take a lot to, like, start it along with the Atlanta Film Festival, or how did that bud off?
Well, we thought that we had, like, kind of a built-in audience, you know, with the film festival and film goers and, you know, film lovers and for indie film. But it's kind of a weird thing. I mean, it's like the 48-Hour Film Project, people just showed up for the 48-Hour Film Project, and they really didn't, like, show up for the Atlanta Film Festival. And so we were like, what's going on? So we just kind of, like, took it as it was. And, you know, and so then when we left, and we took the film project with us, and it's just grown. I mean, it's bloomed. This is, like, the highest number of registrations that we've ever had.
How many? 90?
We had 95 total.
Okay.
And I think, we had 91 teams actually turn in films, you know, so that's a great percentage. And so that's what we're screening, is, I think, a total of 91 films, and it's just fantastic. Last year we had 68 teams.
Oh.
The year before that we had 84 teams, and so, you know, it's kind of, like, gone up and down. And so what's weird is that when it goes down, it's usually because the filmmakers that participate are actually working, like,
yeah,
you know, in film,
yeah,
you know, so they get started doing this stuff, and then they get, like, paid jobs, and then they can't do the project anymore, and we're like, ah, you know.
Yeah.
But so then we have to, like, go after new talent and people who want to do it, but they've always been kind of scared and stuff like that, you know, but they actually end up doing it, and they love it, and they come back and they do it again, and then they usually get hired, and so then we have to go after new talent.
That's so funny. So there's been a lot of opportunities.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, and even this year, I mean, there are probably about 10 teams that are regulars, you know, that didn't get to do it this year because they're working.
Oh,
so,
wow.
I mean, so just imagine if we had 10 more teams. I mean, that would have knocked us over 100. But we're because we got the number of registrations that we did, we're able to say that we are fourth in the world. Yeah, so Atlanta is number 4 in the world with the highest registrations for the Atlanta 48.
And do they give you, like, a limit, or how does it work per city?
No, they don't give us a limit, but, you know, we try to we want to keep the number of films that we screen, you know, in each show to a reasonable amount, because, you know, people can only sit for so long.
Yeah.
And, you know, when you're watching, you know, 12 or 13 films, you know, your butt becomes tired, you know, you kind of, like, forget which film is which, and, you know, and stuff like that. So we try to, we will, you know, set our projections. And then if we start to see, like, a really huge rise in our registrations, then we'll bump it up if we think that we have enough for another screening.
Okay. So basically you would add a screening next year.
Correct.
Based on this year's
break. Yeah.
Wow. And do you have any other projects you've done lately? I know that we met you at the WIFTA event.
Right.
Tell us about that.
Okay, so WIFTA was fantastic. I got to be a judge. I was very honored to be asked to be a judge for the WIFTA shorts. And we had 5 judges, and the films were amazing. They were from all over the place. You know, and I think there were 3 local films. And they're wonderful. And I love the fact that WIFTA promotes, you know, women filmmakers and directors. And, you know, because, I mean, we do need more females, and, you know, in this industry. I mean, it's just a male driven industry, period. And so to have women there, I mean, it's great. And WIFTA is actually the second oldest chapter behind, you know, in the States, behind LA. So so that's great. So,
and speaking of all these great numbers that Atlanta has risen, what do you think of Atlanta today and where it's gotten in the entertainment industry?
Oh, I think it's booming. You know, I mean, the tax incentives have been fantastic. You know, the governor has put together, you know, a great group, you know, to study and to, you know, and to look into what it is that we need to do to help you know, keep bringing jobs here. And, you know, and so while that's going on, I mean, that's, it's just taken off. I mean, I've had so many friends, I mean, that have, you know, gotten jobs in the film industry because of that, you know, and there's so many films going on. You know, I mean, I can like name five people that are working like on five different films, you know, just off the top of my head. Yeah. So it's just great. And I've been able to watch their careers where they just start off as a PA and they work their way up. So, you know, and they start off a PA and now they're like, you know, the head of, you know, doing, you know, set directing and, you know, and stuff like
that. What about yourself? What have you done?
Well, I do this. I do projects. So I'm a project girl. Yeah. Yeah. I love events and stuff. So even though it's kind of like cat wrangling, but yeah.
Planning events. I understand.
Yeah.
I know how you feel. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much for doing this for Atlanta for so long. And I hope that you stick around longer.
Yeah, well, thank you.
I love that it's grown so much already. Yeah.
Well, and you came back here because of the growth, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
So, you can attest to all that.
Yeah, no, definitely. And that's why we have this. So we're so glad. And I hope that we get to come to more of these events and interview the
people
involved.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you once again.
Thank you.
This is Sina Devlaskar with Atlanta's Chosen Time and Paula Martinez.
Thank you.